Dear students, in coming lectures, we are going to discuss the techniques that help us to determine the structure of proteins. But first, we have to understand various chemical reactions that may interfere the chemical integrity of amino acids in a polypeptide. This is important because these reactions may change the folding of polypeptides and may result in various structural artifacts. So, knowing the details of reactions happening on amino acid terminals are very important to fully understand a three-dimensional structure of the protein. Moreover, if amino acids in a polypeptide are changed because of some unintentional reaction taking place due to the presence of some chemicals or compounds in the protein buffer environment, it might have drastic effects on protein's activity. So, knowing the chemistry of these reactions is very important. As we know that an amino acid has two terminals, an amino terminal and a carboxyl terminal. The amino acids undergo reactions on both the terminals. Although many standard reactions or modifications on amino acids are possible, here we are going to consider only two of the most useful reactions. These are esterification of the carboxyl group and acylation of the amino group. The conditions for these reactions must be carefully selected, although the reactions on both terminals do not interfere with each other. That is, the amino group does not interfere with the carboxyl group and vice versa. These reactions are usually used to protect either the carboxyl group or amino group while the other group is being modified or coupled to another amino acid. While doing protein purifications and their subsequent assays, we must carefully select the conditions in order to protect amino end or carboxyl end or both of our protein of interest. In addition to that, amino acids also undergo reactions that are specific to the alpha amino acid structures only. One of these unique reactions on amino acid are the formation of colored product on treatment with ninhydrin. Towards the end of today's discussion, we are also going to see the details of this reaction as well. Let us begin with first reaction, which is esterification of carboxyl group on amino acids. In the presence of large excess of an alcohol and an acidic catalyst such as gaseous HCl, amino acids are esterified. Under these conditions, the amino group is present in its protonated form, that is, in NH3 positive form. Hence, it will not interfere with esterification reaction. The following example illustrates this esterification reaction. Here is a proline residue which has a unique ring formation because of its internal interaction within its R side chain. Because of this ring formation, its amine group is in NH2 positive form under these acidic conditions. So, in the presence of benzyl alcohol and HCl, as shown here on the top and down side of the reaction arrow, its carboxyl group is esterified. The product of this reaction is called a proline benzyl ester, which is 90% pure. Esters of amino acids are often used as protective derivatives to prevent the carboxyl group from reacting in some undesired manner. Methyl, ethyl and benzyl esters are used most frequently for such reactions to protect the carboxyl groups. Thankfully, the reactions could be reversed easily to retrieve free amino acids in its natural form. This is achieved through an aqueous hydrolysis of acid. The aqueous acid hydrolyzes the ester quite easily. Benzyl esters are particularly useful as protecting agents because they can be removed easily either by acidic hydrolysis or by neutral hydrogenolysis, that is breaking apart by addition of hydrogen. So for this purpose, you will add hydrogen in order to remove the undesired component from the compound. In other words, it is a hydrogenation reaction. Catalytic hydrogenation cleaves the benzyl ester, converting the benzyl group into a toluene and leaving the amino acid unmodified again. A toluene is a benzene aromatic ring attached to a methyl group. This is just an information for you to recall its structure. There is another information on the side note, which is about histamine. Histamine is a nitrogenous compound involved in immune responses in the body. The running nose and itchy eyes are the result of its release in the body. Histamine in the body are formed by decarboxylation of histidine. The enzyme histidine decarboxylase catalyzes this reaction. This explains how important it is to protect carboxyl terminal from unwanted reactions to happen. Second reaction which we are going to discuss is called acylation of amino groups. We also use this reaction to separate L and D type amino acids from a racemic mixture of amino acids. Just as an alcohol esterifies the carboxyl group of an amino acid, an acylating agent converts the amino group into an amide. An acyl moiety is normally derived from an acetic acid, and it contains a carbonyl carbon attached to a R functional group. Acylation of amino acid is usually done to protect it from unwanted nucleophilic reactions. In consequence, amino group is protected as an amide. A wide variety of acid chlorides and anhydrides are used for acylation. In the given reaction, acylation reaction of histidine residue is shown. Acetic anhydride is used as an acylating agent in this reaction, and the product of the reaction is N-acetyl histidine. In peptide synthesis, usually benzyl chloroformate is used for acylation to protect the amino group. This results in the synthesis of derivatives known as benzyl oxycarbonyl. A reaction of leucine acylation is shown in this slide using benzyl chloroformate as an acylating agent. This results in the formation of N-benzyl oxycarbonyl leucine. The amino terminal of this derivative is now protected. The amide half of this carbamate ester, or urethane, is more easily hydrolyzed than most of other amides. As discussed earlier, the reactions could be reversed to retrieve amino acids back in its native form. Same is the case for N-benzyl oxycarbonyl leucine. The ester half of this urethane is a benzyl ester that undergoes hydrogenolysis. From previous discussion, we know that hydrogenolysis is a reaction for breaking apart a molecule by addition of hydrogen. Catalytic hydrogenolysis of the N-benzyl oxycarbonyl amino acid in the presence of excessive hydrogen and palladium as a catalyst gives an unstable carbamic acid that quickly decarboxylates to give the native form of amino acid. This also results in the formation of toluene molecule. Decarboxylation means removal of CO2. Please realize from the reaction that a carbamic acid is a compound of ammonia, that is NH3 and CO2. Next, we are going to discuss the reactions of amino acids with ninhydrin. Ninhydrin is a common reagent for visualizing spots or bands of amino acids that have been separated by chromatography or electrophoresis. When ninhydrin reacts with an amino acid, one of the product is a deep violet resonance stabilized anion called Raman's purple. Ninhydrin produces this same purple dye for all amino acids, regardless of the structure of the amino acid. The side chain of the amino acid is lost as an aldehyde. This means that polypeptide is no more intact. The reaction has been described in this figure, where an amino acid reacts with ninhydrin in the presence of pyridine, and this results in the formation of Roermann's purple and an aldehyde. Of course, CO2 is also released as a byproduct. This is a very useful reaction for detection of amino acids on many surfaces. Moreover, it helps to generate fingerprints to resolve some criminal cases. Such investigations are called forensic studies. For example, if you paid a kidnapper with ransom money and the kidnapper has touched it with his or her fingers, the dermal ridges of his fingers leave traces of amino acid on the note from its skin secretion. By treating this paper or note with ninhydrin and pyridine, these secretions on the paper will turn to purple, thus developing a visible fingerprint. So, here is the summary for these reactions which are happening on amino acid terminals. The first one was the esterification of carboxyl group, in which an alcohol reacts with an amino acid under an acidic environment and protects it as an amino ester. Second reaction was acylation of amino groups, where an acylating agent converts amino acid into an acylated amino acid. Third reaction was with ninhydrin, which in the presence of pyridine produce Roermann's purple, and the amino acid is converted into an aldehyde, and of course the formation of peptide bond is also another type of amino acid reaction. We haven't discussed that reaction today. For future videos on various scientific topics, please keep watching this channel, and please do not forget to subscribe the channel.